Let's create a RealtyJuggler task plan. First, I'll log into RealtyJuggler, click on the settings icon, and then on the task plans icon. Next, I'll click on the new task button at the top of the screen. Let's give my task plan group a name of prospecting. The first task in our plan will be to call the prospect. I'll add phone numbers from the prospect by selecting from this drop-down here. We will call 0 days after start date. Start date is the date that this task plan is applied. I can use other dates by selecting from this drop-down here. However, in my case, it is most convenient to have my plan start when I first apply it to my prospect. Next, we'll create a second task with the same task plan group, prospecting. When we use the same task plan group, that means that these two tasks belong to the same task plan. For this second task, we'll send postcard number 1. I'll add in the mailing address to the task description and make this task due 10 days after the start date. I'm also going to add in a category of postcard number 1. That way, when I look at my tasks in my tasks list, I'll be able to filter by my category and list out all the people that need postcard number 1. That'll allow me to streamline the process of addressing and sending postcards when it's time for that. When we look at the task plan screen, we can see both tasks here, and both tasks have the exact same task plan group. You can create as many tasks as you like, and as long as they're in the same group, you can apply them all at once as a bundle. Let me show you how to do that. I'll go to the main screen, click on the prospects icon, and open a prospect record. Next, I'll click on the task tab on the left and click on the Apply Task Plan button at the top and start the task plan group we just invented. The start date will be today, which means that we will start our plan right now. I'll click on the Apply Task Plan button and then click OK. And RealtyJuggler will generate both tasks. You can apply a plan for any record, including contacts, prospects, listings, closings, or even buyers. You can also apply a default task plan so that when you create a new record, your default task plan is automatically applied. Here's how to do that. From the main screen, click on the settings icon and then on the defaults icon. Here are my default records. When I create a new record, this is what we start with. Let's click on the prospect icon and then click on the tasks tab on the left. I'll apply that task plan by clicking on the Apply Task Plan button at the top of the screen. Now, let's go back to the main screen, click on the Prospects icon, and then click on the New Prospect button at the top of the screen. When I click on the Tasks tab on the left, you can see that our default task plan has already been applied to that new prospect record. Let's take a look at all of the tasks for all of my records. I'll go back to the main screen and click on the All Tasks icon. Notice how the icon is displayed in red? That means there are new items that require my attention. From here, I can see all the tasks for all of my records. I can then filter this tasks list in two ways. The first is by category. I can filter my category by selecting from the Show Category dropdown in the upper right corner of the screen. I'll select that postcard number 1 category we used before. Now I can see all the people that need postcard number 1. If you will remember, we had requested mailing information be included. Then here it is. The second way I can filter my tasks list is by date. I'll select Show Category of All so that I can again see all tasks. And then I'll click on the Date Range tab at the top so I can see all the tasks due today. And here's that call task that we created earlier with the phone number. If I click on the edit link here, I can edit my task. If I click on the row itself, I will go to the record that has the task. In this case, I'll be able to make my call, add some notes, and then click on the Tasks tab on the left and mark that task done. Additional information on tasks and task management can be seen by going back to the main screen and clicking on the tutorials icon. Scroll past the video tutorials to the section where the written user's manuals are located. We have a manual for tasks, and it's here. This manual is particularly useful as it exhaustively covers all of the task management functions within RealtyJuggler.